Sorry, what is the second part?
That even if I believe how almighty he is, how knowledgeable he is, why is he so bent on convincing us, look at the mountains, look at the electrons, look at the protons?
Right. The second part of the question was that why does Almighty God give references of the mountain that is created this? For him it is peanuts. So why is he talking? You know why is he saying? He's saying these peanut things, mountain, they would shudder. You human being who are superior, why don't you understand? Quran says in Surah Hashar chapter 59 verse number 21, had the Quran been revealed on the mountain would have fallen down to utter ruin. But to us human beings, it makes no difference. Giving these examples to show that these things which are so powerful, the mountains, etc., which has created, would have submitted their will. Why don't you human beings do? He's trying to give an example that we are fools. He's not trying to praise himself. And whenever he asks us to praise him, or when he says, for this Allahu Akbar, God is the greatest, do you think it will change Allah? No. Whether you say 1,000 times Allahu Akbar or 1,000,000 times, he cannot become greater. He's already the greatest. The reason we face these things is because it is our human mentality, our human nature, that we follow the people who are famous. We follow the people who we praise. For example, your mother has a heart attack. There is an unknown person on the street who gives you the treatment. And you heard that the best heart specialist in the world is Dr. X. Now, will you follow Dr. X's advice or the person on the street who you don't know?
Dr. X.
Why? Because Dr. X is famous. People know him. He's the best in the world. So the reason in our salah, in our life, we say Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, Allah is the most wise, Allah is the most intelligent. Why? If we say that, it doesn't benefit Allah, it benefits us. That if we praise him, we follow him. If we follow, we go to Jannah. To Allah, it makes no difference. Therefore, Allah says, will you not then believe? Will you not then understand? That means the Quran is revealed to the people for understanding. So he's giving this example not to make himself great. He's already the greatest. Whether you say 1,000,000 times Allah is the greatest, it will not make a difference to Allah. He's telling it to you. Allah says in the Quran, Allah does not require you, you require him. So when we praise him, it is human psychology that the person you praise, person you talk great about, you tend to follow his advice. By following his advice, it will benefit you, it will not benefit him. He's already the greatest. He's already the merciful. So these are rules and regulations laid down. He is our creator. He knows our mindset. So the reason he speaks about this, then, such a best. Like, you are a student of science, correct? I am also a student of science. The moment I come to know, Allah mentioned these scientific facts which we came to know today, 50 years back, it increases my faith in Allah. Allah says, in Surah Fusilat chapter 41 verse 53, Sanuri mayatina fil afaqi wa fi anfusihim hatta yatabayyana annahu al-haq. Soon we shall show them our signs in the furthest regions of the horizons and into their soul until it is clear to them that this is the truth. So Allah is giving these examples so that it benefits us. For him, it makes no difference. It is benefiting us, so he is giving us a chance to follow him, so that we can go to heaven. Hope that answers the question, brother.
I recognize his power and I understand he's amazing and all that he's done. But am I expected to be amazed at his achievements at creating this universe? Because for me, for him, it's like a 1 second job.
Correct.
Right.
So for him, which is 1 second job, when he tells you not to have alcohol, if
I
you
really alcohol, sure. But am I expected to be amazed at his creation?
No, see, the thing is that he's not there to prove himself better. If you believe that for him it is peanuts, so will a person lie? No. So if he says don't have alcohol, you will not question him.
No.
Don't have pork, you will not question him.
Yeah, but I'm not amazed at his creation, because for him it's nothing.
Compared to us, it's amazing. For him it's nothing.
Right.
But compared to us, a person who can create the universe, when he tells me not to have alcohol, I immediately follow.
Sure, I don't mind following him, but do I have to be amazed at his creation, as is said in the Quran?
See, as you asked me the question, should I be amazed at the creation?
Right.
I would say, if I believe human being is a better creation, then yes, I'm amazed And then I say, Alhamdulillah, he has made me better than that. So if I'm amazed, he made the mountains, he made the stars, he made the sun. Ah, but he made Zakir Naik also. He made a human being. And we are the best of creation. So he gives these examples so that we realize what benefit he has given to us. All the favors he has given to us. Talking about the science, talking about the protons, talking about the mountains. Finally he says, human beings are the best creation. So in comparison, we have to agree that our creator has created this human body, the molecules, the DNA, the complex thing, which can never come by chance. So in this way, we are amazed at the creation of the human being. And then we submit to him. If you are not amazed, only by being amazed, we submit that he is our creator, he is worth worshipping. No one else can do that. This is so that we worship him and we pass the test and we go to paradise. Hope that answers the question.
If Bill Gates gives me $100, should I be amazed that he has given me that money?
I believe that the question has been answered, and unfortunately we are very constricted for time. You are welcome to come back tomorrow, inshallah. As with all of the brothers and sisters, we have come to the end of tonight's session. So please, a very big thank you.
I'll just give this last. It said, if Bill Gates gives you $100,
should I be amazed?
Will you get amazed? Brother, the question is, why should Bill Gates give you $100? If you tell me a Tom, Dick and Harry gives you $100, nothing to be amazed. Bill Gates gave me $100. It's something that he gave you. Why did he give you? Why not somebody else? Why? The question is, why did he give you is a question.
Okay.
If some Tom, Dick and Harry gives you, if a man on the street gave you $100, Bill Gates.
Got it.
You got it, no?
Got it. I got that.
So now you're convinced, huh?
Yes, absolutely. That is the answer.
So inshallah, I hope that you'll come closer to Islam.
So I should not be amazed at the fact that he's given me the money. I should be amazed it's him who's giving the money.
Alhamdulillah.
Got it.
So it was worth the time extending. Alhamdulillah.